Choosing an extractor fan for your bathroom or toilet can be a bit of a challenge. They all look quite similar. So how do you decide? Should you focus on price, power consumption, noise levels, or the aesthetics? Make the wrong choice, and you might find yourself dealing with scenes like this. Welcome to the eFIXX Extractor Fan Performance Center. In this video, we'll dive into how to compare different fans and uncover why using flexi-duct can drastically reduce the performance of even the best fans. To illustrate our selection, we have chosen a variety of fans, including a low price option, a decorative model, and one from a premium brand. For many installers, a good starting point is to choose a fan that enables compliance with building regulations, which typically specify minimum extract values in liters per second. For this video, we'll look at the intermittent extract performance, which is when you need to remove steam after taking a bath or shower, or remove odors from a toilet. And on paper, these fans all seem to offer comparable performance according to their respective data sheets. So, job done. Focusing solely on the fan is often the first mistake when assessing ventilation performance, as it's just one of many factors that contributes to the performance of the overall system that extends way beyond just the fan itself. Take, for instance, a bathroom affected by mold, which poses serious health risks. Even if the room features an extractor fan that meets the performance standards set by building regulations, we must first ensure that the fan operates when necessary. This may involve using a run-on timer linked to the lighting. However, bathrooms often receive ample natural light, which can lead users to take showers without turning on the lights, resulting in the fan not operating at all. A more effective solution might be to install a humidistat that activates the fan based on the humidity levels in the bathroom. We should also consider whether the fan has simply been turned off. A common reaction to noisy fans that can disturb others' sleep when someone uses the bathroom at night. Selecting a silent fan with a quiet mark rating can effectively address this issue.
If the fan is operating, it's crucial to evaluate the system design, as it greatly influences the ventilation performance. Key design elements include the duct length, the duct type, and the number of bends or restrictions, along with the style of the outlet grille.
The decorative fan faces an inherent challenge, as its front design necessitates a 90 degree turn for airflow, which adds extra resistance. Despite this drawback, many people prefer such designs because they often enhance a room's aesthetic appeal. Let's examine how our fans perform in typical installations. We'll start by testing all fans with a short duct length, representing a common scenario where the fan is mounted directly to an exterior wall. Overall, all fans seem to perform well. By increasing the duct length with the addition of a 90 degree bend and extending the duct, we simulate a common scenario found in integral bathrooms equipped with a ceiling mounted fan. In this case, the premium fan continues to deliver a good airflow, whereas the low cost and decorative fan, the airflow falls drastically. Interestingly, you'll observe that power consumption and noise levels remain relatively constant. Don't be misled into thinking that more power translates to higher performance, or that a noisy fan indicates increased airflow. Noise is created by friction, which can arise from the fan motor design, bearings and impeller, as well as resistance within the ducting system. So, how can you gauge a fan's performance in a real-life use case when, on paper, they seem to have similar performance? A clue is given in the fan curve, which is often tucked away on the manufacturer's data sheet. An extractor fan performance curve shows how a fan's ability to move air or its airflow rate changes as it encounters resistance in the system, or what's referred to as static pressure. First, let's discuss airflow, which is measured in cubic meters per hour or liters per second. This figure represents the amount of air the fan can move in a given time. Higher airflow indicates that the fan is capable of moving a larger volume of air, which is essential for effective ventilation. Next, we have static pressure, measured in pascals. Static pressure refers to the resistance to airflow that the fan faces due to factors such as duct length, bends, filters, or other obstructions. reductions in the ventilation system. A higher static pressure indicates more resistance, making it harder for the fan to push air through the system. So we can begin to understand the performance by comparing the difference between the low-cost fan and the premium one. We can see that with the low-cost fan, the pressure quickly drops as pressure or resistance in the ductwork increases with zero airflow and a static pressure of 20 pascals. Compare this to the premium fan, and we can see that at 20 pascals, it still achieves an airflow rate of around 70 meters cubed per hour. Next question, how do you calculate the static pressure of a ventilation duct system? I ask ChatGPT this, and let me tell you, it's pretty complicated. My best advice, reach out to the fan manufacturer, as they have software tools for this and know the values of the various system components. I've left a link to the design service of EnviroVent, who make this Silent 100 fan. You can gauge the pressure drop by reviewing the data sheets provided by ducting manufacturers. These sheets illustrate how pressure drop correlates with duct length and the airflow speed within the duct. Additionally, you'll notice a significant drop in pressure when 90 degree bends and terminal covers are introduced. So an easy way to minimize tight bends is to use flexible ducting, right? Let's explore how fan performance is affected by the addition of flexible ducting. By adding the flexible duct, we've already reduced the airflow. We see that airflow further decreases when the ducting is either not fully extended or compressed. And therefore, if you must use flexible ducting, keep the length as short as possible, avoid unnecessary bends, and ensure the duct is not compressed.
Now, just to add a bit of further context, adding a 90 degree bend to a ducting system is the equivalent of 16 meters of straight duct. So imagine the difference that adding flexible ducting and lots of tight bends make. The latest revision of approved document F places restrictions on the use of flexible ducting. If you do choose to use it, ensure that it's fully extended and adequately supported to prevent moisture buildup. In this video, we focused on 100 millimeter fans, which are commonly used in toilets, shower rooms, and bathrooms. However, considering ventilation for kitchens and utility rooms, it's essential to achieve higher ventilation rates. To minimize excessive noise and air resistance, this requires a larger duct size and consequently larger fans. EnviroVent also offer the Silent range, which we've highlighted throughout this video, in both 125 millimeters and 150 millimeter variants, all designed with whisper quiet operation. Additionally, there's a wide range of control options, including manual pull cords, adjustable timers, and humidistats. Selecting the right fan is crucial for a successful ventilation installation. However, there are several common mistakes people often make when installing ventilation. After watching this free training module currently on screen, I found myself reaching for the ladders to fix quite a few mistakes that I'd made.